Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Now going down to the cavern, where there is a shadow dragon, I believe, and a shade lord, and then some kind of crypt on an altar that we're supposed to destroy. I have some trepidation going down here, but we should be invisible to the dragon because we have this shadow dragon, yeah. So I have that, and yeah, the shade lord could be an issue, and we'll probably summon the pit fiend again. That'll be pretty awesome. Let's check it out.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Wow, hello? It sounds creepy down here.
I can dance on the head of a pin as well. All the world is blind to my passing.
That goes up to somewhere. The dragon, like, this is a huge chamber. Like, you'd think a good chamber for a dragon.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Like that. Oh, yeah. We can talk to it. Well, I'm not doing that. So I have a feeling that would be an extremely bad idea.
All the world is blind to my passing.
So I'm not sure how this dragon got down here in the first place, although it is a shadow dragon. So maybe it travels through shadows or something, I don't know. There's nothing in here other than this dragon.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil! I won't be as gentle!
And now that... not marked. Okay, we came from that one. And this is stairs going back up. Can one person go?
All the world is fleet of foot and all that.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
We must all venture forth. Is anything back there?
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Yeah, well, we're blind. Actually, the shadow dragon is blind to all our passings. Didn't seem to be anything here.
All the world is blind to my passing.
I mean, we might have been able to just go from here to here, have him wandering around, hiding in shadows, or turn him invisible even, because it failed once, and not even engage a dragon at all. I'm tempted to try to fight it, but I don't know. I think we have a good enough fight coming, waiting for us.
Stand back for justice!
Shadow altar. Right here? Well, we better start now. Alright, I should have put negative plane protection. Bit late now. Shadow Patrick? Shadow Altar.
Your servant awaits.
Who or what should we attack first, right?
Hmm.
I have a feeling it'd be like we can't destroy one or both of these unless we destroy the altar. I have a feeling it's something like that.
I am ready, I think.
Let's just see what happens. Who they go for?
Who intrudes upon me? More unlucky adventurers come to swell the ranks of my dark army.
Ooh. That's a pretty cool voice. I like the accent. You shall have to kill me first. We've gotten past your pet worm. What do you think we shall do to you and your altar?
Bravado, of course. Your kind grows tiresome and predictable, yet you may be of some use to me.
I shall not be used by the likes of you.
Oh, but you shall, mortal. This body that I inhabit grows tired.
Good, we'll kill
it. Excellent replacement. Come, my shades. Open the portal. This brash fool has some strength.
Open the portal?
Oh, my.
Oh, the altar's there. Okay. Hopefully she can cast that spell. We've almost killed the altar. Okay. Next. Oh, that's just a regular shadow?
I'll hurt you if I have to!
Feel the burning stare of my cutstar and change your ways.
Oh, do we have... Wait a second. Yeah, we're protected by evil, okay. Or from evil. Well, don't attack the pit fiend. Having trouble targeting the Shade Lord. Alright, so temporarily we'll attack this thing. The Shadow Patrick, then. And we can do Holy Smite on it as well. I should have got those ready beforehand, but I did not.
Yes.
Is it on the ground? Did it fall? Or is it still forming? I'm not sure. Wait, the Shadow Patrick's going down pretty quickly.
I'll help however I can.
Okay, is it attacking the... Oh, the Shade Lord is blinded. I didn't think the radius was big enough to get him in as well. 15-foot radius, I think it is. Trying to figure out if the Pit Fiend... Hopefully it's not pissed, because that hit it. What happened to this thing? I really want to know. I think it's paralyzed. It's held. Shade Lord is blinded. stunned. The pit fiend is stunned. Oh. Depowered Airy. How dare they? Silenced also. Oh. Am I silenced? Yeah, it was silenced. Okay. I can still use this spell, though.
You point, I punch.
It must be. I'll take these. Some kind of magical chainmail and a halberd. Oops. Okay. Oh, there's just one bad thing. Oh, she's still protected from evil. Okay, good. Are we all... Okay. She's still silenced.
Jacques.
Coney is not silenced, though. What happened? Pit fiend unsummoned. Okay. And we all got a ton of experience and someone leveled up. Airy. Nice.
Yes, Abil?
Heal him for real now? They're stuck in the eternal spell casting. Morella says, freedom from his domination. Thank you. The ranger's words trail off. She is dead. Oh, that's sad. Oof. I heard that. The Shade Lord and his altar have been destroyed. While the old temple remains a terrifying place, its influence on the surface world seems to have been destroyed. Destroyed, destroyed. The mayor of Imna's Vale will be delighted to hear that the threat has ended. Oh, it's a little underwhelming. Ooh, check it out. Over 4,000 gold. Almost 5,000 gold right there. A rogue stone, king's tears, and kind of some kind of charmed, enchanted cloak. Alright, what do we have? She's leveling up from 10 to 11. No proficiencies, of course. She's got priest spells this time. One more hit point. Ooh. Level 1 spell, another level 3 spell, another level 6. 1, 3, and 6. Probably another Cure Minor. Oh, I never have her use Bless. I never use Doom either. Remove Fear. That would be helpful. I'm gonna memorize that. Alright, so you can do another Cure Medium. We could use something else. Cure Disease. Somehow I don't think she wants to be animating undead things. I just feel like that. Ooh, she can have Holy Smite. Right? It's a 15-foot radius, yeah. Seems like a good idea. Invisibility Purge. There's a lot of useful third level spells. Protection from fire, remove paralysis, rigid thinking. ever use Holy Smite. I've been using that spell more often lately. Access to 6th level. Aerial Servant, Animal Summoning 3, Blade Barrier. Ooh. That's pretty cool. I like that. Any creature attempting to pass through the Blade Barrier suffers 8d8 points of damage. Bolt of Glory. That one's great. Especially against demons and undead. What's hardly injured? Elementals, right? Yeah. False Dawn. Undead creatures suffer 66 points of damage. No saving throw. They also act confused on the round after the False Dawn appears. That's pretty sweet with no saving throw. Harm. Heal. If we didn't have two other healers, even with just these two, I think we have enough healing right now. Physical mirror. So it's like a boomerang thing for missile weapons. Wondrous Recall. For any 5th level. Well, anything up to 5th level. I kind of like that idea. Then she could bring on more healing, more fireballs, more whatever we want. Oh, does it have to be? Probably not fireball. I'm sure they have to be priest spells. Whoops. Alright, let's see what we got. Because we got stuff. So let's see if he'd surprise me by using lore to figure out what that is. Duskblade plus 2. Though once a simple halberd, this weapon spent many hundreds of years in a tomb next to the soul phylactery of a powerful lich. The creature was eventually erased from existence, purportedly by another of its kind, but such close proximity to that concentrated evil has imbued the blade with the very essence of night and the chill of darkness. Energy that becomes deadly in combat. It is a foul weapon, and a warrior should use it with caution. Alright, that goes plus 2, damage 1d10 plus 2, and then plus 2 points of cold damage. Why do we need to be careful using it? Thought there was going to be some special thing there that, you know, might take you over or, like charm you into evil. It's a two-handed weapon. Okay. I'm going to put this away because I don't have anyone that's going to be using it. Let's see if we can get this identified. Dark mail, plus 3. Whether by design or through exposure to intense heat in battle, the chain links of this armor are coal black throughout. While legends usually speak of knights in shining armor facing great beasts, the fire-resistant enchantment on this suit suggests equally great, if unheralded, battles with fire-breathing creatures. Fire resistance plus 20%. It's only plus 20%. Armor class is 2. Requires 8 strength. Armor class 1. Armor class 0. Armor class 2. Okay. This also requires 8 strength. And also armor class 2. Zero for slashing and 4 crushing. It's the same. So it's identical, except now we also have fire resistance. Cool. All right. Is that what I need? Rogue stones and a King's Tears. Have I found these before? I know, I remember finding Laurel Tears or something, but I'm not sure about King's Tears. King's Tears are very rare and found only in the realms where they are sometimes called Frozen Tears. Clear teardrop shape, smooth surface, and totally unbreakable so far, by any means. These stones are said to be the crystallized tears of long-dead necromancer kings. In each gem can be seen that which the weeping king loved long ago. Their true nature is unknown, but suffice it to say that sages prize these gems above all others. Interesting. Cloak of the Stars. Thalanta the Fair created many types of cloaks, also known as Cloaks of the Stars. This particular version is simple, with 3 stars down each sleeve. Once per day, each star can be removed and thrown as a dart. The star disappears only to return the next day. Create 6 plus 5 darts once per day. That's interesting. But other than that, it doesn't grant any kind of protection or AC or anything like that, I guess. Well, you have anyone with an open cloak slot? We do, actually. Okay. Yashima's got Cloak of the Stars. Cool. Alright, should we look around?
Yoshimo is willing. All the world
just in case.
Blind to my passing.
How does he get through? Oh. I don't think there would be anything here because we've kind of solved everything, but just in case.
All the world is blind to my passing.
This is a big area. I thought this was just a small staging area for the combat.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Well, let's see if there's any creatures. Any loot. They got a bear?
All the world is blind to my passing. All the world is blind to my passing.
There's a brown bear. We can attempt conversation if we like.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Another bear.
All the world is blind to my passing.
The bear is busy right now. Bear cannot speak. There's a giant lynx. Well, let's get away from that. I mean, they are really fast. So it's over there. Alright, let's head back to our section of the woods here. Failed. Too bright out, I guess. Yeah, not interested. Not interested. I was surrounded by bears. We need to get back. Oh yeah, what's this? The evil of that altar has been destroyed. Some of Amonitor's golden coloring can now be seen beneath the filth of the Shade Lord. Huh. Well, let's look up here then.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Oh, we're up here.
This behavior must not continue. Feel the burning stare of my hamster and change your ways.
That's the same message of that pit. So we're in that same area.
You know, I think the forest likes Boo.
Huh. Oh, what's this? The light in the area is normal sunlight now. We can interact with this, though. And we can go back down if you wanted to. Oops. All right, let's all go.
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo! Run!
Oh, I want to mess with that, actually. What's that? Oh, I don't think we can get there from here. What's that stained glass thing before we leave this side? I would like to be all, have us all present when we mess with this. The light in the area is normal sunlight now. Okay, that's all it does? Okay. Alright, we'll continue westward. Still thinking about going down and fighting that dragon. It's probably not there now. It's probably been banished with the temple going back to the way it was.